for that.
You're listening to Daybreak.
Got the Halloween music, and there's a guy that talks. We don't normally have him.
He keeps interrupting us.
And he keeps interrupting.
He's interrupting you guys because we can't hear him.
So. Dick Taylor and Wendy Smith in studio. Good morning, y'all. How you doing?
Good morning.
Good to see you on these crisp fall mornings. And I know we're going to talk about the airport, and it was so great that finally the funding came through and the FAA did all they were going to do. And you know, I would imagine if only you knew the weather would be so cooperative, you could maybe have done some work. But, you know, you really can't plan for that. You can't bet on that stuff.
And I still don't know if the longevity was enough, you know, even to, you know, because we had the huge rains right before this beautiful weather. And we needed about 3 weeks of good weather. So,
but regardless,
you know, we're gonna
it's on the way.
It's gonna happen.
Yeah, for sure. What else is going on with you guys?
So that particular project, just to continue on that line, is we'll actually officially notice to proceed next Monday,
okay.
So the 4th. And so we're excited about that. Like I've said before, we're going to do the taxiway or the trenching, the electrical along the runway. So they're going to be able to do some of the project prior to the official overlay. So that's good. We were at Small Ports last week, which is the Washington Public Ports puts on in Leavenworth. And so all the small ports around the state get to come together and compare notes and learn things. And it's pretty great stuff.
It's a good conference.
On a scale of port sizes, if you're talking small ports, are you guys on the larger size of the small ports?
We are a larger small port.
I'm just thinking of other ones here in the county.
The others in the county will have, you know, three commissioners and maybe a director. And that's it.
We're definitely on the larger of the small. So if you cut all the ports in large at the top and small at the bottom, we're sitting up at the top of the small.
And
sure.
You know, and we have a $5 million budget, annual budget. $4 to $5 million annual budget, and the other ports are way less.
Sure.
Mason County ports are way less than that.
So it's kind of fun. You get to see, they make it fairly inexpensive to go, and so we get to see a lot of ports that you don't see at all the other port-wide meetings they don't attend.
What are some of the things that a smaller port, some of the benefits, you know, we talk about smaller nonprofit groups and how they're a little more agile and there's less perhaps things they have to get through, or are they coming up with neat ideas to be able to play with the big ports that you guys are able to see or look at?
Yeah, I think so. And what happens at these kind of conferences, they learn things like, you know, how to write leases and do that kind of thing that they don't have the staff to do. And so they'll get advice on how to do that and procedures for running your port, you know, administering your port.
Yeah.
And finances and the legal ins and outs of doing things. All of them have lawyers, but many of them are, you know, they're not on retention and with them all the time. They only use them if they have a lawsuit or something.
Sure.
So they get legal advice or legal counseling, not advice. But.
For example, too, we had our small ports last week, and then Monday I attended an all ports meeting up in Kitsap County, actually, where they have seven ports up there. We have five here in Mason, and Port of Illahee, teeny tiny little guys. They were at the meeting and learned there was a presentation done on RCO grants through the state, so that's through Parks and Rec, and they had gone after some before, but we're told that, you know, they have to provide 50% match, and they don't have that.
Sure.
And so they learned there that they could go for two grants, and one would be the match to the other. So it's creative things like that. And the more you're around the bigger ports or the ports that have done these things or already ventured into that, you learn that. And so it's really, really good information and beneficial. And even on the larger end for us, I mean, we find that a lot of times we're, you know, checking off we're doing this right. Also, it's just you learn something every time.
Sure.
So we did some public works conversations on new laws that have come out for ports for public works, and it's just really good. Really good. I find this conference to be probably my favorite of the whole year.
Yeah.
And I don't go to all of them, but I definitely go to a lot of them. And it's just, I think there's just a sense of, I don't know, kind of family.
When yeah, camaraderie and teamwork that goes on. Yeah, we found out about it. We're thinking about an RCO grant.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a possibility of a grant that one of our tenants, nonprofit tenants, can use.
Yeah. Through that we had no idea.
We had no idea that they did that sort of thing.
Yeah. One of the other things you guys have been working hard on over the last couple of years are those CERB grants, C-E-R-B grants, and two, right? You guys have gotten three now.
You've
got some folks coming through, huh?
Yeah, so the staff person, Janae, called me up and she's going after further funding, and this will be true funding to the program because it is a revolving fund. So the funds that they loan come in and then pay out, you know, the reimbursements. But she's looking for more funding. She hasn't had staff in since inception. I think she's been the one-man show so or one-woman show. So she called me and said, you know, potentially I have a senator who's going to be looking at this bill and looking at the funding and wanted to see and tour some CERB properties. So she said, would do you think your tenants would be? And I said, as a matter of fact, that'd probably be great, but let me check. And so we figured out the date and we circled around. And of course, it's Andy at Lynch Creek and it's Bill Staley at Belco. And they both were thrilled to have anyone come out, you know, and so they're just going to at least a senator. And it sounds like the lieutenant governor was interested. And yeah, so it might be bigger than. So it's in November. We'll do it in November, but we'll tour them around and just show off what, you know, what was and now what is and how much this impacts our community.
Maybe helpful for everyone else out there in the whole state if they go, geez, we're looking here and this, look at all the good work done. Let's keep these going.
Yeah, and that's really key. I mean, the program is fantastic.
Yeah.
It's just an amazing, you know, I kind of like to, as much as you want to sing from the hills and talk about it, you kind of want to, like, keep it for yourself,
sure,
you know.
Sure.
But if they can get more funding, there's enough for, you know.
Yeah.
But I felt really honored to get that phone call.
For sure.
She, you know, it was kind of twofold. One, we're close to Olympia, so they're going to be in Olympia. The other thing is we have three projects right there, you know, in a row. And it just so happens right now that both Belco and Lynch Creek are leasing the one, Frazier.
Mm-hmm.
They're leasing that property too. So it just so happens all the players are all in the same.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's pretty thrilling to be called and be kind of their showcase.
Well, I think I remember when you guys had to go over there and make your presentations.
Yeah.
It seemed pretty good, and everybody was pretty impressed with things happening at the Port of Shelton. Well, Dick Taylor, Wendy Smith, good to see you guys. And thanks for the update on things happening there.
You're welcome.
We'll get you back in before too long and have some more news to share with folks.
Okay. Stay warm.